I am Muhammad Rakib from the Faculty of Sustainable Agriculture, University of Malaysia Sabah, Sandakan Campus. I would like to present my paper entitled Investigation of Ganoderma Infection Mode in Oil Palm Based on their Cultural Morphology and Somatic Compatibility, a case study in Sandakan, Sabah. This is me presenting these slides. Just a brief introduction. Oil palm is cultivated mainly for the oil. So oil palm can produce two types of oil, which is the main one is crude palm oil, CPO, and the second one is palm kernel oil, PKO. So this just to show you that oil palm is one of the most important oil crop. In 2018, the latest one, data obtained from USDA, so oil palm is contributed 73.3 million tons of palm oil, or 36%, and this not including palm kernel oil, which contributed to 4.2, so total of 40% of vegetable oil is supplied by palm oil. Other major oil producing crop, soybean, our main competitor, rapeseed, sunflower, groundnut, cottonseed, and coconut, and also olive. So this to show you where is Malaysia. So now Malaysia is producing 28% of the global oil palm supply, and of course the major producing country is Indonesia, and other are Thailand, Colombia, and Nigeria. In 2018, Malaysia produced 20.5 million metric tons of palm oil out of 73 million metric tons of world supply. This the trend of oil palm plantation in terms of hectareage. So currently, we have 5.85 million hectares planted with oil palm, and Sabah is one of the major producer in Malaysia. So we know that oil palm is very important. However, the sustainability of the industry or the crop is threatened by Ganoderma species causing stem rot. As you can see here, the oil palm collapsed and the base of the oil palm stem already decayed, and this caused by Ganoderma. Another picture to show you that a collapsed palm. If you can see here, the leaves are still green, so it means that it is newly collapsed. You can see the fruiting body of Ganoderma at the base of the stem. Some additional picture showing multiple fruiting body or basidiomata of Ganoderma on an infected palm, skirting symptom. And this is severe skirting symptoms, so most of the front already damaged. For effective disease management, it required knowledge on the disease and the pathogen. So lack of knowledge may lead to inaccurate disease control strategies. There are many studies conducted to understand the etiology and epidemiology of the disease in West Malaysia, but none of them reported the situation in Sabah, which is one of the leading producer in Malaysia. In terms of cultural morphology, characteristic and somatic compatibility of Ganoderma, there are few studies based on the oil palm in West Malaysia, Sarawak and Papua New Guinea, but I didn't find any reports in Sabah. Although I know there are many studies, but there are no published report in terms of their in vitro morphology and somatic compatibility. And the mode of Ganoderma spread in oil palm also least understood. It is known that infection of Ganoderma initiate at the root of an oil palm, and the infection could spread to other healthy neighboring palms through root-to-root contact. However, the root-to-root infection mode is considered uncommon since Ganoderma species in oil palm plantation are genetically heterogeneous, and basidiospore may play an important role. So the objectives of my study were to investigate the infection mode of Ganoderma species in oil palm based on their in vitro cultural morphology characteristic and somatic compatibility. For the hypothesis, this is oil palm plantation in oil palm plantation, if a palm is infected with Ganoderma, okay, we can found that an infected palm having multiple basidiomata of Ganoderma or multiple fruiting bodies of Ganoderma. If this first fruiting body and the second fruiting body have similar characteristic in terms of morphology and they are heterogeneous in terms of genetic, that means that the spread of Ganoderma within a palm is due to asexual reproduction, which does not create any variation. In addition, if the Ganoderma in infected neighboring palm have similar morphological characteristic and similar genetic compatibility or identical in terms of genetic, that means the spread of Ganoderma from this palm to this palm most probably due to asexual reproduction or root-to-root contact. The methodology, samples, a total of 24 samples were collected from an estate located in Sandakan, Sabah. There are three categories of sample collected. First, within an infected palm, among infected neighboring palms, and five cluster of infected palm. For example, this one, okay, this is cluster number two. The ID of the sample based on the cluster number, palm number, and isolate. So for example, C2 means the isolate is from cluster 2, P2 means from palm number 2, and the isolate is isolate 1 from palm number 2. For this one, from class number 2, palm number 2, but second isolate from the same palm. So, two basidiomata of Ganoderma were collected from this single infected palm. Also, from the neighboring palm. Okay? And we have five clusters here as a replication. This Ganoderma were collected and brought to the lab and isolated using Ganoderma selective medium, and pure culture were maintained on potato dextrose agar. So this is how the Ganoderma were isolated from the basidiocarp or basidiomata, put onto Ganoderma selective medium. So the presence of halo brown indicate this is Ganoderma, and this were isolated into PDA to obtain a pure culture. This is how the in vitro cultural morphology characterization was conducted. Isolates were inoculated onto standard 90mm PDA plate. So the mycelia is a dikaryotic mycelia plug, okay, incubated for 14 days in darkness at room temperature. And after 14 days, the data were collected, were qualitative data, and this qualitative data were transformed into 24 codes as in table 1. I will show you later. The data were analyzed where the 24 codes were transformed into binary matrix and cluster analysis was performed. So dendrogram was generated using the UPGMA analysis. These are the in vitro morphology characteristics that were observed. They are mycelia density, mycelia texture, surface texture, colonic concentric ring, surface pigmentation color, and reverse pigmentation color. So the color were recorded based on the color code. The somatic compatibility was conducted by pairing all isolate in all possible combination. So the isolate were placed onto PDA around 2 cm apart. So after 14 days, we assess the plate whether it is compatible or not. If it is compatible, the isolate will merge into a single colony. If incompatible or not compatible, there will be a formation of inhibition zone or barrage between the isolates. results and discussion. This all the isolates, so I explain to you the coding C1 mean cluster 1, pump 1, cluster 1, pump 2, number 1, cluster 1, pump 2, number 2, and so on. So from this, we can see that there are variation among the isolate regardless where they are isolated, either within the same pump or from the neighboring pump, or isolate from different cluster. Okay, so only isolate C5P2 number 2 show distinct characteristic compared to other isolates. They are dense at the center, rough, the metal texture is rough, and surface texture is strongly wavy, and so on. So just to show you that there are variation among the isolates. However, from the dendrogram generated, we can see that there are very low variation or very narrow variation, which was only from 93% until 100%. This is different as reported in other study where it was conducted in Sarawak, where around 50 isolates were collected and show variation between 60% to 100%. But for this, a smaller number of isolates and showing narrow or lower variation in terms of the cultural morphology. And only two isolates showing 100% similarities, C2, P2, number 2, and C2, P3, number 2, show 100% similarity, where these two isolates were collected from the same cluster, but different pump instead, neighboring pump. And later I will explain to you, although they have similar characteristic in terms of cultural morphology, but they not necessarily have similar kinetic compatibility. Means that although the phenotype is similar, but the genotype can be different. Variability are common in other phytopathogen, and they are related to geographical origin and phenotypic changes. These phenotypic changes can be due to transition induced by environmental changes, random phenotypic switching, and antigenic variation. So the result for somatic compatibility, these are 5 examples. The first one, A is showing compatibility reaction, where this is control, means that same isolate are placed onto this plate and these two isolate merge into a single colony. So this for the control. And for other, all of them are non-compatible except for this one, C5P31 and C5P32. These isolates are compatible. These isolates are collected from the same cluster, 5, same pump number 3, and first isolate and the second isolate. So these two isolates are from the same pump and showing compatibility in terms of genetics. However, among all the isolates, only this isolate showing compatibility, which means the spread of Ganoderma within an infected pump could be due to asexual reproduction. Means that from one point of the infected pump can spread to other part within the pump via asexual reproduction. For C, it's showing incompatible reaction here, the inhibition zone. These are from the same cluster, from the same pump, but different isolate. It means that within a pump, same pump, there can be multiple strands of Ganoderma infecting the oil pump. So not a single strand, but multiple strand of Ganoderma is possible to infect the Ganoderma. And for DNA, incompatible reaction between isolate from different pump, from different cluster. Okay, this one is from pump 2, pump 3. This one is pump 1, pump 3. The findings based on the somatic compatibility also supported by other researchers, where they further tested with molecular level using AFLP analysis or amplified fragment length polymorphism. And this suggests that dispersal of basidiospore play an important role in the epidemiology of the disease, as the basidiospore become infective through the buildup of inoculum source. Hence, preventive measure to minimize the basidiospore spread should be taken for better disease management, such as removing as much as possible inoculum source in and around the planting areas that later develop into fruiting body, and removing existing fruiting bodies. So for the conclusion, there was narrow cultural morphological variability among the Ganoderma isolates, which was 93% to 100%. Ganoderma isolates may exhibit similar phenotype but not necessarily have similar genotype and vice versa. Only isolates C5P31 and C5P32, which were isolated from the same affected palm, showed somatic compatibility, which means they are genetically identical. Generally, a single palm could be infected by multiple unidentical strains of Ganoderma, and the infection in the neighboring palm also caused by unidentical strain of Ganoderma. Last but not least, this further conclude that the spread of Ganoderma species in all palm due to root-to-root contact is not common, and the basidiospore dissemination may have played an important role in the disease epidemiology. That's all from me. Thank you.